Hey guys, this is Mick, and today we're going to be doing book review number 7. But before we start, I would like to make a confession. I had a little episode of OCD. This is why you see black books sorted here, white books here, red books here, blue, and a little bit of yellow over here. Last week I was walking on the streets of San Francisco and I saw this bookshelf where the books were sorted by color, and I thought I should try that at home, and this is why you see this. And but anyways, today we're going to be talking about the book Nonviolent Communication. Nonviolent Communication by Marshall Rosenberg. So this book was given to me by my sister. She implies that I have tendencies to communicate violently, which is true. Often I get angry or I get emotional and I don't know how to express my feelings. And this book really teaches how to communicate your needs internally for yourself as well with, when you communicate with others. One of the interesting things is that this book explains you this of way of how to judge and evaluate any situation. For example, first thing that you do is you observe what happened. If somebody parked and blocked your parking, this is a fact, this is something that happened and you can observe that. Then identify the feeling an emotion that you had with that, with this. And it could be anger, it could be frustration. Then find a way to understand what's the needs, what is the need do you have, and the values that you want to communicate, and then communicate the request. Communicate not demand somebody to do something, but actually communicate the request. And the difference between demand and request is that when you request, you are okay with people not doing it. And often in our lives happen that we demand people to do something that actually brings this defensiveness, and this is why people fight. So I think it's a very important book. What I also found interesting is that this book talks communication with others, but communication is with yourself, because very often people are suffering from depression because they are going back in time and start thinking about negative things that happened to them, and they keep asking the same question, and they judge themselves and they evaluate themselves instead of just looking for the needs. So instead of just judging yourself and go to this infinite loop, just figure out what are the needs that left unfulfilled for you. What are the things that you can do to express and to fulfill those needs? And this is how you can help, the strategy can help actually to get out of depression and make you be less violent communicator, not just with others, but with yourself as well. So there's a lot of good nuggets about this book. I highly recommend it. I give it 9.5, but it's not the book that you can just read it and forget it. I really have a lot of highlights here, and this is something that if you really want to master, you have to go back and review and really practice it. And this is why I'm gonna put this book somewhere closer so I can review it on a regular basis, because even knowing the strategy for nonviolent communication, without practicing it, you can't really make this everyday life, and you can't really make it useful unless you practice. Because even understanding it, you can understand it, but unless you practice it, you can't really stop yourself in the middle of when you have the anger or when you have a certain negative emotion before you actually say something mad or you raise your voice or anything like that. So highly recommend this book. Again, it's a Nonviolent Communication by Marshall Rosenberg. I give it 9.4 out of 10, and I hope you're gonna pick it up and enjoy reading. By the way, this book also includes a lot of good information of how to resolve conflicts and how to mediate between parties when the conflict arises. So thank you very much. Have a good day. Till the next time.